So when we say authentication and authorization, what's the difference here? Let's take a look at authentication first. This is the process for verifying identity. This can be done through a number of methods. OAuth, API keys, Java Web Tokens are good ways to do this. Of course, MFA can be valuable here and stands for multi-factor authentication. On the other hand, authorization is about granting permissions. Once you've been authenticated, what are you actually allowed to do? This needs to be stated explicitly somewhere. Role-based access is an excellent way to take care of managing authorization in an organization. An interesting way that OAuth helps out here is by providing scoped access tokens, which limits the time for access to make sure we don't unintentionally leave a resource exposed for longer than we want to. When looking at auth and auth, we've got to consider some best practices. And when taking a look at best practices, we always want to make sure that we consider both authentication and authorization. So what to do here? Always use HTTPS. Never ever use unencrypted hypertext transport protocol. It leaves all of your data open for bad actors to consume. Also, you've got to make sure everything is up to date on the latest patch levels. And revisions of software. These are easy ways for bad actors to gain access to your application through your API.